Hey, you came a little late.
That's all right. We're out drinking.
They're busy.
Guess you should go drink with their mom later, yeah.
I am.
Oh, shit. Hey, Mom, we have a burlap sack racist. I was going to say racist, but no, you're not a racist. You're only a rapist. So I'm sorry, son. You're a racist rapist? That sounds like an awesome PlayStation 2 game. The racist rapist. So, yeah. He's got his camera ready. All right. So your final comedian of the evening is about to come up. Please give it up for... I'm gonna do it.
Rachel Gentry!
You guys said that slower, it was so hot. Please give it up for Rachel Gentry, everybody! Oh, here she is.
Holy shit, it's bright up here. I can't. How you guys doing? You guys are embarrassing me. Mom, the comedians are backstage talking about having sex with you. The only way I can like get them off my back is like, look, she's racist. You don't want her. I guess like an argument could be made that you aren't, but like it's weird because like my mom, I think she is racist, but it's hard. She made up her own stereotype, so it's difficult to tell. Like, this one time we were driving, and we were behind a car, and the car had a vanity plate on it that said, Muhammad. And the light turns green, and the car didn't go. And my mom just yells out, okay, buddy, quit playing with your dildo, Muhammad. Like, I'd like to say that her racist personality didn't rub off on me. But I think I'd be lying if I said I didn't almost always assume that anyone named Muhammad had a dildo, drove around with it, and played with it at red lights. So I always assume that. We have some girls here tonight. Girlies? I feel like every girl group has like a certain like, there's like five, it's like a boy band that makes up a girl group. You know, you got your she devil, the girl that looks physically like a bitch. Like born with bitch features. If she was born and they came out, they're like, oh she's gonna be a lovely bitch. There you go. Like Angelica Pickles. You guys know what I'm talking about. She's the girl that's like in charge of all the pictures that are taken, like the queen bee. She's like, alright, I like alright guys, get here, get in, everybody! Like you're Christopher Columbus discovering America, except you're a gay flamboyant Muppet. Suck it in, into the text! I like to do with these girls if they ask me to take a picture, because I'm never invited in because I like doing it. I just like to like press record. Just like let them go. I'm like, yeah, I'm taking a bunch. Just like look at them like looking so fucking stupid. Just like you look like a gay grizzly bear. Insane looking. Girls will do crazy things to look skinny in pictures. Like I was taking pictures with my cousin. We were in Paris. We're pairs of young girls being ditties, and she kept wanting to take selfies, and we kept taking them, and she would look at them immediately afterwards, and she'd be like, we have to delete this. I have like eight chins in this picture. Like, you sound psychotic. Like, fat people don't even have eight chins. They have like maybe one at best. I feel like girls are gonna start doing like crazier things to not look fat in pictures. Like they're gonna do something drastic, like get their necks removed, and then we're gonna have to deal with that. You know, like they come up to you and they're like, "Rach, I just got the surgery. What do you think? You look like Uncle Fester." The like a skinny Uncle Fester. Yeah, skinny Uncle Fester. What about the girl who has to sneak her engagement ring into every picture? Even if it's like not called for it, it's like a crop from like, oh, we're just doing, it's a crop from like here. Oh, okay, yeah, no, let's, yeah. That's crazy. I mean, I guess tag it? I would tag it. I call that girl the wifey. She's always the girl at the beginning of the night that's like, I just like want to get wasted and dance. But then like by the end of the night, like her man's picking her up. She calls her boyfriend her man, by the way. He's my man. I just like to put my engagement ring on his tummy when we take pictures. He's full, okay? I'm just gonna rub it. He's my man. He's my little bear cub. My man. I have a girl in the group here tonight. Andrea, where are you? I call that girl the baby girl. Baby girl don't give a fuck. Baby girl do her. She's the girl that coined the term, sorry, not sorry. I don't even fucking care. Cram it. I'm just making this stuff up, guys. I'm just...
That is so true, though.
Just me. Oh, Jesus. Does anybody watch porn?
Ow!
I can't see anything. Porn. I started watching porn, but I was afraid to watch it for a while because I always like thought like people would know. Like for some reason, like my Scrabble stats come up on Facebook, so I don't know like what goes on. Rachel was just watching like a whole gangbang. Oh, is there one? Mom, do you know what a gangbang is? She's like, I was in college. Mom, I'm glad you got here early so I didn't have to like hear you like bump around furniture like, oh, sorry. But porn, you know, like I never watched it. I mean, I hadn't really watched it, so I was like very nervous, like that somebody would catch me. You know, I Google a lot of embarrassing things. You know, I feel like I shouldn't have to hide that though. Like I feel like I shouldn't. I feel like I should be able to look at BuzzFeed 17 reasons why hot dogs are the most erotic food on earth and like not feel guilty about that. Like, it's okay. So I started watching porn. Like I just watched all of Mom, like all of them. Like, one of my favorites is, you know, the one where the two girls are fighting over the dick. Like, in what world, guys, is that, like, two girls, like, it's mine, Tiffany! Fuck it all night! No one's, the dick is like that, it's like a Stretch Armstrong dick. It's like, it's a big dick. Those girls really want to, like, they really want to suck it. They're like, no, like, no, you go ahead. No, you, no, no, it's totally, like, I'm a lady, of course, that's why. Suck it. The gay guy porn is, like, intense, like, I can't even handle it. Like, it was so intense, and, like, what's even more intense is that they haven't even, more intense, like, pop up on the side of another gay porn video that's, like, muted and almost, like, more interesting than the actual porn that's going on. Like the one on the side was, like, you know, I'm, like, watching this one. The one on the side's muted. I don't know what's going on. There's no voice. There's no nothing. So I just, like, see this one guy, and, like, all these dicks just start, like, cornering him, like, arrowing him, like, his neck, like, spears, just, like, one after the other. And he just looked... He just had no idea what to do. Like, he was so, and I was just like, I gotta find out what happened. Like, he looked so, just like, you know, like, which dick do I suck? So I was just like, two dicks to the left. Like, clearly, that's the one. My favorite porn was straight porn, obviously. That's the best porn,
oh,
right?
Oh,
that's not fun. The girls are really into it.
Fuck yeah.
The porn banter, the back and forth, the verbal exchange. There was a girl, a lady, giving a guy, a gentleman, a blowjob, and he was coaching her because, let's be honest, she needed coaching. He's just bobbing the head. You know, he's doing all the things. He's telling her, and he's like, oh yeah, girl. Ah, yeah. And then he goes, keep your eye on the prize. I'm sorry.
I love this part.
Is your semen, your cum, the prize of this scenario? Like, think about that. What if you went to a carnival and you had that beanbag and you knocked over all the jugs of milk? And instead of a big stuffed bear, the carny just comes over and he's like, here you go. You kept your eye on it, I saw you. That's ridiculous.
No.
I had a friend that told me that, like, every time before her boyfriend came, he would ask her if she wanted it. Like, I'm a lesbian. Is that a thing? Like, I don't know if, like, do guys do that? We don't need to do that. We don't ask. But I would think that, like, what girl wants it? Like, no girl needs it. Like, if anything else besides semen came out of that hole, I don't think a girl would, like, stop the press. Like, wow! Is that Dr. Pepper? We're gonna do this again! We're gonna get it right! I told that joke to my dad in the room one night, and, like, afterwards I was like, oh my god, I told that joke, and he's like, Dr. Pepper? I would've gone with, like, orange juice or something. My dad's a ridiculous guy. He told me something interesting recently. Is anybody else like a child of 90s divorce? You know what I can't really see? No? He's like ducking. Yeah, okay, you. Like, I realized that the 90s divorce kids are like, we're a special group of people, like, with a divorce. Like, our parents really didn't know what they were doing. Like, nowadays, like, somebody gets divorced, they're like, look, your dad sucks a huge dick on a Tuesday night. We're done. Like, that's that. You get it. You've seen the movies. Like, but back then, like, you didn't really know. Like, my dad was born in 42. He was alive when Hitler was alive. Think about that, Mom. That's your business, not mine.
It's
just great having you here. Back and forth, but
I wish my mom was here.
You know, they
but seriously, I wish
who said that? Was that Haley? Your mom made for a teacher. I'm glad she's talking about semen. But you know, my dad, he came up to me recently. He's like, you know, I never told you guys this, but I, you know, when I told you guys about the divorce, I stole that speech from Mrs. Delphine. I'm like, you know, Mrs. Delphine, it's just Mrs. Delphine. There's no S on that. Mrs. Delphine, that's what I said. I'm like, all right, you French Canadian, well, I'm just gonna let that one slide. But yeah, but think of how crazy, like, that was 90, like, 94, whatever. Mom, do you know? No, you don't. The VHS tape. You had to go to the video store, rent it.
You had to be kind of real.
Put it in. Fast forward, or watch it if you're feeling frisky, I don't know.
Be kind of real.
Write it down and then recite it to your children. It's a lot of work. But, you know, a father's got to do what a father's got to do. I just feel like he didn't need to dress up like her, too. Like, he could have done without that. He, like, walks in, he's like, toodaloo! What's going on? He's born in 42, but he tries, like, so hard to be, like, young and, like, hip and, like, with it. Like, he found out, like, what the fist bump is, and he's been embarrassing me with it, like, all over town, like, using it incorrectly, just, like, hurting my street cred, and I'm just, like, not, I can't have it. For example, like, I woke up one morning, like, so hungover, like, eyeliner on my chin, something's in my bed, guy, girl, dog, I don't know. Rough night. I come downstairs, like, last thing I need is some bullshit. And my dad's like, Rich, you look like you just got back from a whole house. And I said, wait, he does it to me in public, and then, like, he dances it, you know? He's like, oh, like, get your Robin Williams knuckles away from me, you know? But then when I deny him that fist bump, he just, like, leaves it out and just, like, shames me and, like, layers me in guilt about it. Like, just, let me see that get a fist bump. And like, yeah, like one day I'm gonna be like over his deathbed, like, Dad, why didn't I just fist bump you in the Walmart parking lot? Guys, that's what regret feels like. All right, that's my time, guys. Thank you very much.
Give it up for Rachel, everybody. Rocking it in front of her mama. I can't believe, like, Rachel's mom's here and my mom's here. It's like an intervention for two of us. Yay, mom. You actually, mom, can I tell the story of us smoking pot together? All right, I'll leave you on this. So the first time I ever smoked pot with my mom was also the last time I smoked pot with my mom, because it got too real. Have you ever smoked pot with Rachel? No.
Yeah.
It got too real. Let me tell you what happened. So my parents have this sweet fire pit behind their house, and it's like me and my mom, and she's like, Ian, you should roll up some of that dank shit. I don't think she said that, but she was like, oh, you should roll up some weed, right? And so I roll up a joint, and it's just me and my mom. I take a couple puffs, and I pass it to my mom, and she takes a couple puffs. She passes it back to me. I take a couple puffs, and on the second pass, I give it back to my mom, and she's like, glassy eye, right? She's like all, like, cloudy, right? And she takes the joint, and she's like, little tiny hits, and staring into my soul. She's staring directly into my soul. Taking a little tiny, staring into my soul, staring right inside of my being. And finally, after like literally 4 minutes of her staring, she breaks the silence with one giant inhale. And she goes, you came out of my body. Hi, too. Hey. Ruining it for both of us. All right, energy is worth it, guys. Give it up for all the beans you saw tonight. Woo! Thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
Hi,
guys.
Hi.
Do you want to do it again?
We should probably get it again.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, it's better that way. It's way better that way.